Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, I have my old compressor here, this Denso compressor. I took out my IS300. So on today's video, what I'm gonna show you how to do is take off the clutch and the wheel here in case you actually have to swap this out for any reason. Then we're gonna go ahead and open the inside of this to see what's inside and just do a whole tear down. Since I'm not gonna be using this compressor or turning it in for a core, it's just a spare compressor for parts for me right now. So stay tuned. So this compressor, I took out my IS300, it's about 20 years old. It still has the magnetic clutch right here, which is still good. It wasn't the what went bad. I think internally the seals went bad. That's why I had to replace it, but we still have this. We still have this sensor right here. So those are still good parts that I'm gonna just save in case my other one or any other compressors I have go bad. This magnetic clutch usually doesn't go bad, so it's usually not the culprit. It's usually the inside that goes bad, but we'll go ahead and just tear this whole thing apart. So take the clutch off. It's pretty simple. It's a 10 millimeter right here. And then once you take off that front cover, the rest of it is just a bunch of shims, a snap ring, the actual rotor right here in the middle, and then the clutch itself or the stator and another snap ring, and then this whole thing slides right off. So we'll go ahead and just try to do all that. Once we get in there, we can start taking apart the screws and everything that hold the compressor together. So I'm just gonna go ahead and try to shoot off with a regular impact driver to see if it comes off. It's only a 10 millimeter, so it's not on really tight. So that thing comes right off right there, nothing. So to get it open, they actually sell a special Toyota tool to pull this whole thing out. But I could use a standard puller like this that you just kind of screw together here. And then basically just put a screw with a nut on the backside and grab the holes, the four holes here, and just pull this whole thing out. Then once it comes loose, just don't go too far because remember you have that screw in there that's holding it. All right, once we clear that out, you should be able to just pull this thing and then it comes right out. You're gonna have a shim. So the number of shims it shows on the thing as 3, but you could have as little as 1, I guess, because right now mine only came with 1 right here. So as far as that goes, we need to get something to pop the snap ring. I don't have a snap ring tool, but you should be able to just take two screwdrivers and kind of pop it out there. So what we're gonna do is take two flathead screwdrivers and just kind of twist them, and then you can pop the rings out far enough to kind of clear it up. So there's a snap ring we removed here. Once we remove that, we should be able to pop it out, but I think it's pressed in there and just years of corrosion have kept that thing stuck in there. So you actually have to pull it out with something now. So to remove this wheel right here, we basically just got to tap it out with a mallet. So we'll go put it. If you order this thing from the factory, you actually have to order this mount. You have to order this separately as a separate part and put it all together versus buying it from Denso as a quote unquote aftermarket, even though it's still the OEM. All right, so we got the actual spinning wheel part, the free wheel. So this is a good spare part. So the last thing you need to do is take the actuator or the magnetic part of it off. So this one's actually got the electronics to it. So you want to unbolt the electronics, take all this part. Right now we'll go ahead and take apart all the harnesses and the wiring on here just to get it off. Then this thing's also held on by a snap ring on the inside. This one actually requires a real snap ring remover, which again, I don't have, so I'm gonna have to finagle my way to pop this thing out. All right, so what I'm gonna try to do is just basically get a flat head in there since I don't have a snap ring remover and try to pry it sideways so I could get something underneath and pull it up. It's a little bit pain in the ass, but I've never really had to use a snap ring remover until now. All way, little snap ring pliers would have made quick work of this. All right, once all that comes out, pretty much just wiggle it until it comes loose from all the rust and corrosion. And this thing comes right out. The back plate is just a steel plate back here. There's the magnet in the middle, and then that's all the areas that we kind of messed up on the inside, but that's all cosmetic anyways. And then as far as this goes, the shaft and everything is pretty clean there, but again, we're not gonna reuse it. And if you're probably doing this, I don't know if you're gonna be reusing this compressor, but you're most likely gonna be reusing the magnet here. So tear down this compressor and take it all apart. You basically just need to take apart these 8mm bolts right here and then separate everything out so you get the inside. Once that separates, you can feel the thing come apart, and then just open the inside, and here we have it. Compressor, you can take the little gasket off here, and separate the backside. It's like a bearing plate here. Oh, but yep. So here's the backside. Got springs inside. This looks like a sandwich plate of some sort with a gasket. Yeah, as it moves around, see these pistons right here? They move up and down. And that's what does all your compressing. Obviously this stuff's not serviceable. When they rebuild the compressors, that's what they end up taking apart and rebuilding all the seals inside those pistons right there. But for what we're doing, this is all out of curiosity. So I took off everything on the head gasket and everything. I'm gonna just go ahead and just try to pull this thing out so you could pretty much pull all the pistons out and you can kind of see them each fall out. So over time, then these things are pretty light. They're almost like hollow, but over time, these are what end up failing, and they don't seal anymore or compress anymore. Each one of them has these little rockers inside. It's like a cam. It kind of spins around in there, assuming each of these is the same exact bore. So when you buy aftermarket, it's probably the quality of these things, the quality of the bore, even remanufactured ones. I'm not even sure what they remanufacture when they do that, but just looking at the cross hatching on the inside, see if there's any damage. Cause again, over time, this thing doesn't have enough oil in it, it might end up scoring the cylinders and then you lose compression. So here's all the parts taken apart. Pretty amazing that they can sell this thing for like $200 back in the day. Obviously it's gone up to $400 now with all the price increases, but yeah, just getting one of these things for 200 bucks OEM from Denso just amazes me how they can make it for that cheap with this kind of machining and precision to have everything work properly. Especially for 200,000 miles in 20 years. We sure did get our money's worth out of this thing coming from the factory. Hey guys, thanks for joining me all the way to the end of this video on breaking down this compressor, taking it all apart and just kind of showing you what's inside. This was all straight out of curiosity. Most likely, any of you guys trying to replace a compressor, you probably won't ever have to open it up or even take the clutch off or anything to swap it over to a new one. The IS300 is a weird animal. Like I said, if you bought this from the dealer and paid the dealer price for this thing, you actually have to buy the compressor separately from the clutch and then put it all together and make it work. Where if you bought this from Denso as sort of an aftermarket, even though it is an OEM Denso replacement, it all comes in one piece, which is weird. Anyway, if you guys found this video informative and useful, give it a thumb. If you guys haven't subscribed to your channel, go ahead and subscribe to your channel, turn on bell notifications to get notified every time I post a video. For all these different projects, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys next time.